Welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be going over company settings within Salesforce. So now I'm going to be doing a high level here over company settings, and this is often covered in the admin exam. I do have a Salesforce admin exam video course on Udemy that is very, very long, goes into a lot of depth here. Just high level, if you want to check that out, I will put the link in the description down below. So without further ado, let's jump into it. So I'm going in to setup, and then I am going to go into the quick find and search for company, if I can spell, company settings. Okay, so there's a lot of different things that are encompassed within company settings, and I do have a lot of videos actually on the YouTube channel and in the course that cover most of these. So let's talk about business hours. All right, so business hours is the first thing. This is going to help with a lot of different automations. Business hours, if we go into default, are going to be when your business is open. Of course, this says 24 hours. This is going to be very different based upon different businesses. Now, you can choose to set this up or choose not to set this up. You can also add holidays here. Business hours, essentially, what they do is they will dictate any time-based automations that you have. So when it comes to cases, case escalation roles, case auto response roles, even lead response roles, sometimes can be time-based. And so let's say you work typically Monday through Friday, 8 to 5 every day. And that's when your business is running, with maybe a lunch hour in between there as well. And that's when your service people are going to be working on cases. So let's say after 8 hours, you also had a rule after 8 hours, if it's not responded to by a rep, then let's move it up in the chain. And every 8 hours subsequently, that would go further and further up the chain. So let's say it's 5:30 on a Friday and you get a case. It's not going to be responded to until like 8 a.m. Monday. And so that could go way up the hierarchy. If it goes every 8 hours, that's at least 6 times going up and up and up and being escalated until it's going to be reached, or it's going to be dealt with on Monday at 8 a.m. So if you have this 24-hour, 7-day-a-week thing and you're not actually doing that, it can really mess with your case auto response rules and case escalation rules. So just keep that in mind when you are setting this up. If you are setting up case escalation rules, that it could really mess you up if you are escalating things on a 24-hour basis when people are not going to be working on a 24-hour basis. Now, holidays, let's talk about those real quick. We can add them and they will pause your automations. Like, let's say you turned off Saturday and Sunday for 24 hours, then your auto response and your escalation rules would not run during those times. I guess I should say your escalation rules would not run during those 48 hours that you were not working or not business hours. Holidays do the exact same thing. They just kind of pause the escalation rules, so they will not go during the time of the holiday. So like Christmas, if you have the Christmas day off, then it'll pause those automations. So that is a high level view of business hours. Of course, you can have different business hours and assign those to different automations. All right, let's talk about calendar settings. So calendars, you can have public calendars and resources. Personally, I don't really use these. A lot of companies do not use these, but it's good if you are connecting it with like a Calendly for your sales reps to have like a public calendar full of company events. So that's really what they're used for. Company information. I think that this is really important. It helps you and helps Salesforce know who to reach out to. You can edit the org with all this information when your fiscal year starts, your currencies, anything that is high level about your company and about the org. It could be really important actually to take a screenshot of this so then you know what your instance is. So sometimes Salesforce goes down or the server goes down, and so this instance number will help you go and check out if the instance is down or if certain functionality within your Salesforce server is being upgraded or patched or changed. So take a screenshot of this so then you at least you know, or write this down. Here you can deactivate your org if you're looking to end your contract. Primary contact, let's say I left Call Solutions, which is highly unlikely because it's my company, but let's just say we did. Then we'd want to change the primary contact here, or else Salesforce might reach out for a deal or to renew a contract, and so you might want to change that up so then they know who to reach out to. Here you can see your file storage and your data storage, and if this gets too high or low, you might want to rethink your contract. Here you can also see your licenses and how many licenses are being used, how many are left, and their expiration date if there is those. You can also see your permission set licenses. Permission set licenses help us, and feature licenses as well, help us to enable more functionality within Salesforce. And so sometimes you might need to buy functionality depending on the functionality you want to use. That would be for these feature licenses, such as marketing users or flow users or knowledge users. And then we have usage-based entitlements. I haven't actually used these, so fun fact there. And that is high level of the company information. So a few things that you might want to pay attention to here, other than the used file spaces and data storage, is multiple currencies. If you're looking to do multiple currencies, then you'll need to check that and actually activate those currencies. And then also when your fiscal year starts, it's pretty common for your fiscal year to start in January, but you could move it around depending on what your company needs, or if your fiscal year is a little funky and maybe you do trimesters or whatever rather than quarters. All right, let's go to data protection and privacy. This is just giving access to your data. Then we have fiscal years. Again, this is where you can set a fiscal year. You're starting beginning, end, January, February, whichever one. This is going to help with reporting. This is going to help with forecasting. So if you were to change this and move this around, it would kind of mess up your forecasting, possibly your reporting and your quotas. So make sure if you are looking to change up your fiscal year that you know that. You can also go to a custom fiscal year. This cannot be undone. And so you'll need to understand and probably come up with a game plan for your company to set up custom fiscal years, set up custom forecast, quotas, reporting, and change that all around. So that is my little spiel on custom. I do have a video on that. I'll try and link that on setting up custom fiscal years. And then we've already gone over holidays. It just helps to pause the support team hours that they are available. And we have language settings. You can enable other languages. And displayed languages. You may need to upload a translation key to Salesforce depending on the language. And then finally, we have My Domain, which helps to have a custom domain for and login screen possibly for Salesforce. And routing, as well as some other policies and authentication. So that is a very high level overview of the different things that are in company settings. A lot of these are going to be set it and forget it stuff, such as like the fiscal years, holidays, business hours, but you may need to come in every once in a while and update these. So then your company is running as smoothly as possible. So if you have any questions on this, be sure to leave them down below. I'll try to get back to you as soon as possible, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.